माइक्रो कर्नल आर्किटेक्चर। माइक्रो कर्नल आर्किटेक्चर इज ए सॉफ्टवेयर डिजाइन पैटर्न दैट एम्फेसाइजेस मिनिमलिज्म बाय सेपरेटिंग द कोर फंक्शनैलिटी ऑफ सिस्टम फ्रॉम एडिशनल सर्विसेज एंड फीचर्स। इन दिस आर्किटेक्चर द माइक्रो कर्नल प्रोवाइड्स द एसेंशियल सर्विसेज नीडेड फॉर द सिस्टम टू फंक्शन व्हाइल एडिशनल कॉम्पोनेंट्स एंड सर्विसेज ऑपरेट इंडिपेंडेंटली एज प्लगइन्स और मॉड्यूल्स। Let's see the key characteristics of this architecture. Core functionality. The microkernel includes only the most fundamental feature necessary for the system, such as communication, resource management, and basic scheduling. Additional functionalities are provided by separate modules that can be added or removed without altering the core system, allowing for flexibility and customization. So we have core functionality and we have extension. So core functionalities without which the system won't work. Extensions are which can be added to add more functionalities to it. So that is why it is flexible in nature. Inter-process communication. The architecture often relies on inter-process communication or IPC mechanism to facilitate communication between the microkernel and its plugins or modules. Right? The microkernel and its plugins or modules. Modules are isolated from each other, which enhances stability and security. A failure in one module does not necessarily affect the other. And it is kind of similar aspect of microservices architecture also. There it is just a service, here it can be a module. Now within module we can have services as well. Modules can be loaded and unloaded at runtime, enabling dynamic updates and resource management. Let's see the benefits of this type of architecture. Modularity. The separation of core and additional features promote a modular design, making it easier to manage and maintain. And if you guys are familiar with content management system, let's say for example Adobe Experience Manager, which uses OSGI framework where we can deploy different bundles. Those bundles are different functionalities, different services, and independent of each other, right? They can be uninstalled, installed, can be activated or deactivated at runtime. So that is also a modular for modular application. So somehow that is that CMS, the Adobe Experience Manager, is also using this architecture, microkernel architecture. Scalability. New features can be added as independent modules, allowing the system to grow without significant rework. Flexibility. Users can customize the system by adding or removing modules according to their needs. So for example, I'll create a new jar file, I'll add new functionalities to it, I'll just deploy this, and this jar file can be plugged and played. Means if you deploy this jar file to another system, it will work. So that way it is flexible in nature, it is reusable, and it is scalable. Enhanced reliability. Isolation of components increase the overall reliability of the system, as issues in one module are less likely to impact the others. Now let's see the use cases of this type of architecture. Okay. Operating systems. Microkernel architecture is often used in operating systems where the core functions are kept minimal and additional services like file system, device drivers are run in user space. Then embedded systems. Suitable for embedded systems requiring high reliability and real-time performance, where flexibility and modularity are essential. Plugin based application. Ideal for applications that benefit from an extensible architecture such as web browsers or IDE, where users can add plugin for enhanced functionality. So this architecture is particularly beneficial for systems that demand high modularity, flexibility, reliability, allowing for a clean separation between core functionalities and additional features while enabling dynamic updates.